Hi folks, how are you all doing today? So today, off the track, like let's start creating a game. Okay, we left creating games long back, right? So I just want us to continue that. And today we are going to learn about a new lab also. Okay, we have not used Sprite Lab in our videos. Yeah, maybe sometimes while doing the courses we might have used, but we have not really created any project on this officially, right? So today we are going to create a game using Sprite Lab. Okay, to just create a Sprite Lab project, you just have to click on create and then click on Sprite Lab. It automatically just gives you this page. Okay, so again, this is almost the same kind of interface. You have the blocks and everything like this, right? So I'm just writing catch the apple game and then save. So yes, today we are creating catch the apple game in a very simple way, yet it is very interesting. Okay, so a very simple logic we are using on this. So let's start off creating the game. Before starting off with anything, I would like to tell you all guys that if you have not been watching my previous videos yet, please do go back to my channel Folks Hub and do watch them. If you are new here, please do subscribe to my channel. Okay, and yes, so let's quickly start off with today's content. Okay, which is catch the apple game, right? So first I'm just setting the background to some background like this. Any background you can set basically, right? So I'm just choosing this one. Let's suppose you want new background, you can just click on more and you can just see there are so many backgrounds over here. Okay, just choose anyone, whichever you like, right? Then let's click on sprites. I'm just taking this, make a new sprite. Okay, so I'm just creating a bowl sprite first. Let's set the size of our bowl. So I'm just setting the bowl size to 120. Yeah, I think it looks good, right? So let's go to sprites and let's get another, make new sprite. So I'm just taking the apple sprite, okay? So let's change the position of bowl sprite to the bottom. And then let's set size also. So I'm just setting the size of apple to 50 is fine, I think, right? Now, so for counting the score, I will also create a variable for this, okay? So variable, what is a variable and all, we already know. If you have not been watching my previous videos, please do go back and check out them. Okay, I'm creating a score variable, going to math to get 0. Yes, so set score to 0. Okay, and we have created these things so far, right? Now apple has to fall down from here, right? Whenever it touches that, then we have to get a point. Okay, so to do such a kind of a thing, what exactly we are doing is, so I am just quickly changing the position of your apple. Okay, so it has to jump to, so click on sprites, you will get this jump to random location block. Okay, so who has to jump? Apple has to jump, not to random location. Instead, we'll just manually set the locations. Okay, so y value I'm just giving, so it has to come from top, right? So I'm just giving 380. Okay, so I think 380 is good. And x value, instead of writing 100, let's go to math. I'm just getting random integer because it can come from anywhere from left to right, correct? So from here, like 22, I think x can be 380, right? So from 20 to 380 we can give. Let's just give the same thing. 20 to 380. 380. Okay. Now, so this will be y 380. It is already at 380, right? So let's just make the x value random and y value, it has to come from top always. So that's why I'm just writing y as a constant value like 380. Okay. Now we have to set the behavior for our sprite. So sprite begins. So which sprite should begin? Apple should begin moving south. Moving south means it will come downwards. Okay. So let's go to behaviors and get moving south behavior. Okay. So we can also, we have moving south and looping, right? Let's also check with this thing how it works. If not, we will just use moving south. Okay. Now, this is not enough, right? This is not just enough to do the thing. We also should be able to move our bowl left and right. So for that, we have events when up arrow. So instead of when, I will be using while so that it should continue. The bowl should be moving continuously when I click on the left arrow. It should not be like I have to again and again press it, right? It will be annoying for the user to do that. So that's why I'm not doing it. Okay. Then go to sprites and move bowl sprite 10 pixels. Okay. While left pressed, then westwards. Okay. So then again go to events while right pressed, then you can actually copy paste the block. Ball should be moving eastwards. Okay, so this is for left and right movement, right? What should happen whenever your apple touches the bowl? So for that, let's write the event when apple touches bowl, right? First thing we'll be doing is again I'll just make apple jump to random location because it will just go down and down and down. It will never again come back when it is moving south, so that's why. Okay, so I'm just doing this thing, I'm looping thing, right? I mean behavior has to be the same thing, right? So that's why I'm doing this. Okay. And then we'll change the score also by 1. So let's click on variables to change score by 1. Changing score by 1 means incrementing the score by 1 each time, okay, whenever it touches. So to print something, we have the print block here. So I'm just getting print. I'll remove this and I'll get the variable score, okay. So that means it will print score on the screen. Then I'm using if conditional statement to show the winning screen. Okay, so if score is equal to 20, or yeah, the score is equals to 20. Then we'll go to text and get this show title screen, right? So let's show the title as congratulations. Okay, you won. Right? And then Apple has to stop everything after that. The behavior should be stopped. So that's why I'm just placing this. Saying Apple stops everything. Okay, so let's check out what exactly happens with this and whatever we were thinking of is working or not. So whenever I touch the apple with the bowl, it is printing the score. Along with that, it is also giving me another apple with the random position. So if I get score 20, then I should win the game. Okay, so if you are missing the apple, it does nothing, it just stops the game there. Once after I'm winning the game, I will show you how that also works like. So yeah, yes, we won the game and you can see that it is stopping the apple now. It's not moving south because we stopped everything once the score became zero, right? Okay, you won. Now let's just miss the apple and see what happens. See? Oh yeah, we have looped it, so that's why it's just looping itself, moving south and looping. Wow. It just loops itself. This is fine. Cool. Cool, right? I absolutely love this. Great. So if this is done, then I think we don't really need this thing. Let's check this without these blocks also. Okay. So run. Comes from the same position, right? It is not going to the random position. So what if I just say this? Okay, it's coming from the random position now. Same position. Same position. So it is coming from same position if it is doing that. When I touch it, then it is coming from random position. If not, it will come from the same position. Okay. However, this is also nice, right? So we could successfully complete this thing. Right? Any questions you have, you can absolutely comment in the comment section below. Okay. So right after doing this game, if you are adding more features onto the game, you can do let me know about that. Okay. I'll be very happy to see how you have created this game or have you made your version of the game, right? So please do share your projects with me too in the comment section below so that I can see how creative my students are. Okay. So yeah, this is all about our today's game and I hope you like this game. So we could just do it in a very simple and easy way, right? So only a few steps, a very simple logic could create a small game like this catching the apple thing, right? And this is becoming almost like an infinite game. So that's why we just stopped it with the score, okay? Not to really embarrass the user by again doing it the same thing again and again. So if the score is 20, then we are ending the game saying congratulations, you won the game. Okay, so this is all about the game and I hope you all like this. So please do like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel Folks Up for watching more content like this. Okay, so to see more content coming up for you, so you just have to subscribe to the channel Folks Up. Also, there are so many videos which are already present in the channel, right? There are around 80 videos so far. So please do go back to my channel and watch all of those. You are gonna really have some fun and definitely you'll be learning something very new which you've not learned before. Okay. So yes, this is all about today's session. Bye-bye guys and hope to meet you in the next session soon. Thank you so much for your support and please support me like this. And yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Bye-bye, guys. Have a great day, all.